Okay, it's May 13th, 2018. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. And we're out here finishing up our garden. We still got a few things to plant yet. Broccoli and well, a few other things I don't know yet. My sunflower window fence. Let me see if I can look on here. The camera's cracked. It's broke underneath here, the thing that screws into the pedestal stand. So now I gotta be careful with it. That's a elderberry, and that's an elderberry right there, and that chicken wire fence around it. And Lucy and CJ's gray. Lucy, CJ's got some pretty flowers around her. Got torch sunflowers in the middle, right by their grave, for them for prettiness. They get the big butterflies and everything. I miss you, girls. Over here on number one, we've got okra. We have three or four red okra in the first row and a half. I'm not going to be able to go through all these because I can't see on this viewfinder out here. But there's four red okras out here. Then we got some green spineless okra. I think we have six or eight out here total. And then we have two green and two yellow zucchini, squash zucchini. And plus we just planted out purple. The purple is the closest one with the big tomato stake. Sweet. No, that's purple. The lemon basil and the sweet green basil. Bunch of seeds in each of those, so they'll start growing. Then we're going to transplant them around the garden. And we have 140 garlic right here, heirloom garlic. So we've got some sunflowers that we're going to have to get out yet too, because if they're torched, they'll take over. We'll have to get rid of them. Beans and peas. The corner is a sweet pea. The back corner, I planted sweet pea. Over there, there's two of them growing in the corner. They're growing. And then there's one back there that floods, back where that paint can is and all that. Nothing's going to grow there, but I planted them anyway. Black-eyed peas, we got two over there growing. Two in the middle over here growing. And I have various beans over here. The three round cages right here, chicken wire, is purple hull peas. I've got three planted in each one. I know I have at least two in each plant growing. Then I have, I don't even remember the names anymore because they're all heirloom. Bean down there is growing. I planted two. Planted two in all the holes. There's two growing down, or one growing down there in that first one. And I got, there's a bush bean right over in here. Inside there I got, I think these are Tiberius. One right down there and one on the left there that goes to that fence down there behind the swing frame, which is what I have these other strings tied off to the crawl to. See, these torch sunflowers are going to bush out all around the garden though, so I don't know how well it's going to be when those start getting bushy. You've seen on past videos of the torch, it gets really big, so what we're gonna do with that. But I got one right here, that's where the other pea was, sweet pea, green pea. And there's two I believe black-eyed peas down there. And then in the back garden here, we've got 19 tomatoes out. We've got five or six over there in those pots. We've got 19 of them, different varieties out here. Usually they're the ones that give you about the pound or better tomatoes. We staked them today. Really cool. It's going to be a really good garden. Even if even a third of what we have planted comes out, we'll have more than we've ever had. So, because we have so many things planted this year. And over there we've got, and I'm not even walking down there. The far west end is two watermelon growing, or three maybe. And there's another hole with two in it. And there's another hole with one. And there's a hole with honeydew. And then there's another hole where I had two seeds of honeydew. Nothing's come up yet. I planted four seeds in three holes of cucumber. Nothing came up. My wife transplanted one cucumber. It's growing. Plus, we planted two seeds in three holes. All six of them are coming up. So, and then there's a plant down there. We don't know what that is. It's growing from last year, I believe. But I'm going to wait for it to grow up a little bit more through that hole. We've got room for at least two more things to go up near the, this is the northern end that I'm standing on. That's the southern end back there. So we got at least room for two more things, perhaps three. Because we have peppers, well, that might be what we do with peppers. But the peppers can go, like, you know, on an angle here, if you can see right here, and then back between, after that tomato, before that pink windmill, right there, pepper. All along the back, we can get peppers. So we've got the bunch of peppers, too, planted in pots. They're not doing so great yet, but again, they've only been about a week in the pot. And the heat's just starting. Yesterday and the day before, it was kind of warm, hot. It's supposed to get up to 90 today, 91 tomorrow. And my sunflower wall, or fence, I call it, mostly yellow sunflowers. But you got a few torch, which is like that one, the tall one there. It's like a bush with the orange flower heads. It gets the large winged butterflies, hummingbirds, and honeybees. That's why all these flowers are for, mainly. I'm going to attract the honeybees out here. Then they can pollinate the tomatoes and the cucumbers and the watermelons and all that. We'll have a big, big bounty. These are all yellow sunflowers. There's a couple of torch in there I can see. The leaves are a little bit different, but on that. And then I think there's a weed there. I can't see too much of the viewfinder right now. Just no mind that that was a transplanted torch. It doesn't look so hot. But it's not dead. This one too is transplanted, but it's not dead. So if water today, this evening, it might make it still. It's Sunday. Tuesday we're supposed to have rain. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, at least 50-60% chance. So it means with the heat too, it gives you pop-up showers. Dead one right there though. God, this thing is broke. I have to take this off with a tripod. Because the screw that goes into the bottom of the camera has broke a piece off the bottom of the camera. So while it's video recording, I take that off like that. See, this piece is what screws into the bottom of the camera. And the piece that this screws into is broke on the camera because it fell over from the winds out here. So it's hard to use this tripod now because the camera's broke. I won't ever get a fucking Sony again. Excuse my mouth, but that's what I think about fucking Sony. Piece of shit. Name only. I was told that before, but now I know. Okay, these are the torch sunflowers here. These big leaved ones. Bushes. I think I put some yellow sunflowers down here and some torch mixed. So my northern wall here, I won't see this because it's going to be corn. In about 2 months, you won't be able to see any of that. You will not see anything on the horizon. Nothing at all. The corn will be right 20 feet, let's see, I say 30 feet off of this garden is where that corn will be. Back there is 150 feet, that's where it'll be. And then all the way around. Okay, this is the, this would be the western wall of the sun garden, the sunflower garden, flower garden, flower fence, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to step closer to the garden, I'm going east right now. Okay. I can't see on it, so I hope it's recording. Yeah. And this is the west end of number 3. See, my main came down there anyway. Watermelon down there, 2 or 3 transplanted. Holes are off of previous plants, but as long as we keep them somewhat closed up, I've cut off some of the corners anyway, but there's a majority, 85-90% of the ground is covered with this plastic. It heats it up about 10-15 degrees warmer than what the ground is, so that's why I say things that take heat, this helps immensely. Those tomatoes should take off in about another week or two. We're going to have them up about 2 feet. And I don't know if the wind just cut all that out or not. I got my hand over the mic now, but said that the plastic will help this stuff take off big time. It's heating up the ground about 10 to 15 degrees warmer with the sun, which we are right in the middle of the open. And you can see the Monsanto is about, I'd say close to 100 feet across the road there is Monsanto. And from the garden over, it's about 40 feet. It's about 15 to 20 feet from my sunflower, which I wanted to use that to block from all that crap. But 19 tomatoes right now, at least 7 cucumbers growing right now, that are growing, but there's about another 18 to 20 planted seeds, just in maybe in a bad area. I've got one honeydew or cantaloupe growing, and I have 3 more planted, and I've got 5 watermelons growing. Oh, look at the little toady. I thought I took off his back leg earlier. I don't think so. Cutting up the grass inside the plastic here. All right, happy Mother's Day again. Here we are out in the middle of nowhere. I don't count this country. I mean, that house over there is about a quarter mile away. Country is like a mile or two. Actually, there's a road over there called Tinsley Road. If that was what the closest house was in any direction, I'd say, yeah, we're out in the country. This is not country, especially when you got a road right here, right in front of you. Anyway, it's private enough. We are fortified and we can take care of everything out here, trust me.